Welcome back to Fallout 4. It's time to explore the secret Vault 81. So we know that there should be experimental mole rats in here. Or mole rats that have been experimented on, anyway. So they might be particularly nasty. Maybe they'll be extra strong, maybe they'll have venom, who knows. But let's make sure to thoroughly search for any information about what went on down here. Fuck, that scared me. I was not expecting that. Caution. Okay, there's another one nearby. What was that sound? Okay, so mole rats may spontaneously jump out of any dirt. Let's keep that in mind.
Well.
Oh, here we go. This might have some information about the experiments they were doing. Public terminal. Breeding program update. Mole rat breeders. We finally got the breeding program stabilized. As earlier reports indicated, the mole rats show unusual degrees of aggression in captivity. This may be due to the growth hormones. Recent generations seem more docile, although some of the keepers are complaining that the lab animals are watching them, which is preposterous. Serum production. We have created 197 distinct serums that can treat 36% of known viruses. This is a modest improvement from last year's 33% treatment rate. However, 11 of the serum account for 61% of the treatment results, which is encouraging. At this time, only 19% of serums have the potential to be mass-produced. We have tasked our latest robot lab assistant to find ways to synthesize more of them efficiently. Want to come out of here? I guess not. Good. That's a protect drone. Oh, dog meat, watch out, watch out, watch out. Don't go into the line of fire. Dog meat, just go back here, okay? Go, go.
Hold.
Where's that protector on? I didn't kill it. Oh no, I did kill it in one hit. Okay.
Hey, come on!
A duel! I can give that to whatever his name was. and get 15 caps for it. Aw, yeah.
Yes.
What was his name? Clive? Clive Owen? Chad? Clave? Cloven? Started with a C.
Nice.
Come on, dog meat. Come on. Come on. You can't attack a turret that's on the ceiling. Your doggy powers don't extend that far. Okay, I may be going a little bit loot crazy because of my newfound weight carrying powers because of the Lone Wanderer perk. Maybe I shouldn't be picking up every single glass inside of the cafeteria. What's my weight looking like? 226 out of 290? Oh, plenty of room. So what I would like to know is, why was this place sealed in? Why was the old secret, Vault 81, just sealed? Is it because the mole rats went out of control? So they did it to protect everyone, because they didn't know how to deal with them? This probably just controls the turrets, but let's do it anyway. Cure, like this one. C-U-R-E, no. C-U-R-E, no. Nope. Could be? Probably not. Oh, two of those match, okay. Nope. 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 Not too many options left. Camp. That could be it.
Yes.
There we go. Dectron control. Don't think I care about doing this. Medical responder. Activate, sure.
Out. Bring up. Protectron on duty. Protect and serve.
Oh, it's a legendary Protectron.
Protect and serve.
Research and maintenance. Okay, research is definitely where I want to go. Should be the epicenter of all this. Oh. What the hell? Did that mole rat just, like, die while trying to get into its burrow and then it just, like, rigor mortis set in or something? Are you alive? Or- oh, ew. Nope, definitely not alive. Okay. I wonder how they got all this dirt in here. So they could pop up at any moment from this dirt. I'm not sure sneaking is really gonna help much. There's no point in sneaking at all.
I'm sure this whole thing is overblown and Austin will be running around tomorrow.
Overblown or not, we have to do what we can for Austin. I just don't know what I can do.
Neither do I, Priscilla.
Why him? He's just a boy.
He's going to be just fine. You'll see.
What is this? What did I just hear? Hydroponics observation terminal. Wait. They can observe the new vault from inside the old vault? What? What? Subject, hydroponics. Status, occupied. The crop rotation implemented by the hydroponics manager has proven successful for supplying the vault with adequate food. We have not had to intervene, which has eliminated the risk that the vault inhabitants would discover the secret part of the vault. So far, they do not appear to suspect the true nature of their vault. The greenhouse would be a perfect place to introduce class C4 and D1 viruses into the population, as well as potential cures should a disease get too virulent. I'm recommending installing hidden sprayers in the ceiling. Ah! That's right, every vault was set up to do some sort of a test, some sort of experiment. Ours, in Vault 111, was to test the effects of long-term cryostasis. Theirs was apparently to be guinea pigs to whatever they felt like testing, which is why there's a vault within a vault, the secret vault. That's why it's hidden, and that's why you can observe the people of the other vault through windows and stuff like that, so they could observe the effects of their tests. So is anyone still alive to observe? Given the mole rats everywhere, I'm guessing no. The mole rats took over. They tested a little bit too much, went too far. Could that be why the people of Vault 81 are working so hard to keep the place running? Is this vault here completely self-sufficient? Or instead, is there a chance that perhaps this vault leeches off of the supplies of the other vault, taking away power and things like that? And making it harder to maintain than it seems like it should be, because you have essentially two vaults to take care of, instead of just one. That could be a thing. Research. I heard them. Where are they? Talk to me, where are they? Show me, boy!
a joy for you. You get to nag me and I can't go anywhere.
Oh, real nice, Holt. Make this about you. Don't you think about anyone other than yourself? Your daughter could get sick like Austin, and you're whining about spending time with your family?
I have things to do. We don't have to hide away in here.
You're so busy, Holt. You have so much to do. Please, explain to Aaron why your needs are more important than her safety.
Just never mind.
Idiot.
Depot occupied. The vault inhabitants have unexpectedly repurposed this room to be a kind of store for selling and repairing their possessions. It has allowed this observation port to record interactions between many of the vault citizens. This shop will become an important disease vector for spreading airborne Class B2 viruses. It will also be valuable for observing the effects of disease on social and economic relationships. This room will become a backup treatment location, along with the commissary. The primary will still be the clinic under the assumption that severely ill patients will all be taken there. Was that below us?
Intruder. Identify yourself.
Oh, hi.
Hostile target
that
identified.
One's glowy.
Attention. This is now a combat zone. You may suffer harm up to and including death if you remain in the area. This notice required by law.
Jangles the moon monkey. I think I've got like at least four of those.
You and your staff are to make sure every resident remains under stringent medical observation.
Understood. But overseer.
No buts. This is for the good of the vault. We can't risk this pathogen spreading, Dr. Forsythe.
Yes, Overseer.
How is Austin doing?
Not good. The infection has progressed quite rapidly. We need a way to stop it from spreading.
Then let's hope that outsider pulls through and gets us a cure.
Although the chief scientist argued against an observation port in the Overseer's office, it has turned out to be a boon. We are able to observe the political shifts in governance since the vault door was locked. When we do introduce viruses to the population, we will be able to monitor the leadership's reactions and courses of action. Finally ran out of room. Dog meat, take my burden. And that's it. Okay, I'll be a little bit more careful about picking up stuff now. Only got 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I've got like, I don't know, 50, 60, 70 pounds of extra room. So I'm not going to pick up every enamel bucket. I'll take the dog bowls. Backups for dog meat.
Sweet.
I'm going the wrong way. The brood mother. Get him, dog meat. Ah, disappeared again. No, there you are. Gotcha. Vault 81, tech password, ooh. Research comm terminal. Probably what the password's for. Alright, well before we actually read that, I want to take a look at these, the other places around here. Where did I come from? Because I kind of ran in a hurry to kill the broodmother. Requires terminal. That's not. Oh, I came from. Yeah, I came from there. All right. Went there. Went there. Oh no! No more room. I wonder if it's the hides that weigh so much. Sort by weight. Oh wow, this thing just gives you steel and it weighs 5. That's not worth it. This gives you fiber optics, though, crystal, that's pretty important stuff. Gear, that's important stuff. Steel's not. Screws, those are important. Spring, important. That, nope. That, nope. Alright, got about 13 pounds to work with. Good enough. Okay, now let's read it. Let's see, interlink status error, comm active null, admin credentials, all of it. User credentials, Collins. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing Dr. Olivet, do you copy? I do, Kenneth. Everything good over there? Just another drill day, right, Overseer? It is. And thank God for that. Where is everyone? Overseer, there are just 3 of us over here. What's going on? All of it. Are you getting this? Sorry, Kevin. It's been a madhouse on this side. Only three. Myself, Jim Flint, and that kid, Burrow. Where's everyone else? Not over here. Residents are being admitted. They started showing up in droves once the news started broadcasting. That's the same way I heard. You'd think Vault-Tec would have had enough warning to call at least a beta drill for staff this morning. Something must have gone wrong. Phase 1 trial. We've been pretty limited down here, but we've been focused on antibiotics and have our first Petri trials underway. I saw the data last night. It's promising. But do you think it's ready? The trials just started, and the virus we're going after has a few days of inoculation. But I'm optimistic that later this week we'll see positive results. Okay, keep me posted. And don't begin phase 2 trials until I have an opportunity to go through the new data. Of course. Have a good afternoon, Overseer. Okay, so Olivet was the old Overseer, right? And wasn't she the Overseer in the other vault? And Overseers are usually given special privileges, and they know things that the normal people in the vault don't. So it sounds like the Overseer, the old Overseer, used to actually know what was going on, that they were testing drugs on their citizens, basically. Food extruder issue. Overseer, do you have a minute? The system isn't instantaneous, Burrow. I hope you haven't been waiting for a reply all morning. Sorry, Overseer. I wanted to notify you about an issue with our food extruder. Okay, I see it now. Looks like a clog in the protein tank. You weren't able to address it on your end? No, Overseer. Hardware failures on the residential side must be addressed over there. We can't get to the tanks or nozzles to repair them. Okay, Burrow. I'll have maintenance down there immediately. Go stand by and have Collins contact me if there are still issues in about 10 minutes. Okay? Thank you, Overseer. I'll go there now. Oh yeah, they knew. And I'm guessing Gwen probably knows. In fact, I wonder if it's Gwen that messed up the old Overseer's computer. The one that nobody could get inside of. Maybe she read those files, realized what had been happening, put a stop to it, but then told nobody? I don't know. And yeah, it looks like that is the reason for all of the maintenance. Because they're doing maintenance for two vaults, essentially. And some of the issues, it looks like, can't even be fixed without going into the secret vault. Some can only be fixed on one end, and others can only be fixed on the other. Phase 2 trial. Good news, Dr. Olivet. We've tweaked our formula based on Phase 1 trial results, and I think we're ready to go with Phase 2. How's the mole rat population doing? Very well. The specimens Vault-Tec provided are remarkably hardy. Flint has been doing some radiation testing on them. Is that in the protocols? Not technically. But we noticed some weird stuff with the kibble provided for them. Burrow got pretty sick for a day or two. Don't ask. Flint's been looking into it. These suckers are big to begin with, and we're thinking it's genetic. Tampered with? Something like that? I think Vault-Tec... Huh, and then just cuts off. Delivery... failure. Overseer? Yes, Burrow, what is it? I've noticed an issue with our delivery mechanisms. Do you know if anyone has tampered with the nozzles in the residential quarters on your side? I don't know. What are you doing with the delivery system anyway? The Phase 2 trial just began. I know, Overseer. I just thought it would be a good idea to run tests on the delivery system before we reached Phase 3. If we reach Phase 3, human trials are not to be undertaken lightly. What kind of tests were you hoping to run anyway? Just a placebo vapor, to make sure the nozzles are dispensing mist properly. The... something. I don't know why it keeps getting cut off. Please answer. Doctor, please get in touch. I know what you've done. Honestly, I don't blame you. Performing the Phase 3 trial on non-consenting humans is a breach of ethics, at least according to the world we used to live in. I can keep Burrow together for a while, but Flint's already suspicious. What are we supposed to do over here? I can only lie to them for so long without some actual response from you. Damn it, Olivet. You can't be such a hypocrite that you'd condemn us to die in the name of your personal sense of morality. I know your politics, but I never thought you'd actually leave men for dead. Please reconsider this. Ah, so Olivet didn't want to keep being their person on the inside, helping them to run these trials. So she cut them off, stopped replying, and I guess left them to die. Because they're deeper inside of the vault. They're deeper inside of the vault, and if the people kind of, I guess, more outside the vault decided to stop supporting them, if Olivet decided to stop supporting them, stop fixing their stuff and all that, I guess they'd, I don't know, run out of supplies, or maybe she cut off power to them or something, who knows. I wonder if Gwen knows about this. Pretty sure she does. Use the password on this thing, there we go. Oh. Those are graves. You know, it's kind of disrespecting the dead, but I want to take one of these Vault-Tec lab coats. Because I want it to wear. Oh, I've already knocked over the floral flared face. Well, I've already desecrated the grave. Yoink. I'm sorry. Actually, I could probably wear the coat in place of my, my vault jumpsuit? Possibly? Let's see. The patch suit would take everything off? Okay, what about the coat? Ah, the coat would also take everything off. Damn. It also offers no protection whatsoever. Only thing it does is give you 2 more intelligence. Oh, hello.
Oh, another stranger. Are you Vault-Tec Security? I've waited so very patiently for you to arrive.
Sure.
Yes. Yes, I am.
Superb! I placed an emergency call so long ago, I was beginning to think something dreadful must have happened. I am pleased to report I completed my primary duties 83 years ago. Thousands of pathogens were grown in the mole rat hosts. Then a single broad-spectrum cure was developed to treat them all. Very satisfying work for many decades. Now, please tell me you are authorized to release me from the lab.
What's with this option? Heck no, I'm just a guy looking for the cure. What? I'm not a guy. I wonder if they forgot to change the line.
Why can't you just leave?
I require verbal or written authorization. Actually, any Vault-Tec employee, even you, could authorize me. You must be Vault-Tec, or you couldn't possibly be here.
I am so authorized. You are released.
Superb. I had almost given up all hope of leaving here. I'll open the door for you. Since you are a Vault-Tec representative, I entrust you with the broad spectrum cure I developed. If you have an equivalent to my digital Hippocratic Oath, please use it quickly to prevent any undue suffering. However, be advised, there is only one dose left, and I can no longer make any more.
How convenient. There's only one infected person.
If that is all, I am most eager to leave.
You only have one dose?
That is correct. There used to be more, but they all expired. Sadly, the organic compounds necessary to make more have all deteriorated.
Thanks for the cure.
It is my hope that this cure finds its way to someone who needs it. Hopefully now I can properly further my scientific research. Since my job here is done, I think I will follow you out.
Okay. Not gonna leave just yet, though. Medicine bobblehead. Stimpaks permanently heal 10% more damage. That is really nice. I see you, microscope. And now I'm carrying too much. Damn. There we go. Good enough. Curie's terminal. I just realized her name is Curie, and she gave me the cure. Is that supposed to be a joke? This terminal is now for the exclusive use of CVRIE for both research and personal purposes. Why is it a V instead of a U? Please respect her privacy and use other terminals for your own work. Thank you, Dr. Collins. Research. Date of last data purge, unknown, memory failure, okay. Personal. Entries of the personal work and property of Curie. Do not read, yes, this means even you, Dr. Collins. Initializing greetings, laboratory. I've been ordered by Dr. Collins to add an entry to this terminal. Dr. Collins was most insistent that this is my terminal. I explained several times that robots cannot own property, as per Robco policy. But his orders were most clear and insistent. I will comply with Dr. Collins' wishes and maintain a log when ordered to. Colleagues, I have completed my analysis and integration of the data to make me a capable research assistant. I have been commanded to provide an assessment of my colleagues. Dr. Flint is objectively brilliant, although Dr. Collins repeatedly calls him brusque. But I find Dr. Flint's commands and speech patterns easier to parse. His observations are always very astute, and I'm learning much about working with cell cultures from him. Monsieur Burrow is perfectly acceptable to work with. He performs menial tasks, which my programming is perfectly suited for, such as carrying heavy lab equipment. This is strange, because my capabilities for such a task are far... What? Okay, why do these entries keep cutting off? I get the feeling that this is not supposed to be like that. I think there might be something wrong. Error in cache integer. Aww. Distress. Unusually agitated state. He would not leave his quarters after his morning meal. Dr. Collins assures me the state is temporary, and that Monsieur Burrow is merely overwhelmed with the something. Eulogy. Dr. Burrow is deceased. Postmortem indicates he expired from a severe cardiac arrest, brought on by advanced age. He died at 5:01 a.m. shortly after waking. In accordance with the doctor's pre-existing orders, the body was cremated and placed in the specified urn, alongside Dr. Collins and Flint. Dr. Burrow was of great assistance in continuing the work left to us by the others. My last order was to continue working on our projects alone, so that our deaths will not be in vain. My processors are fully committed to furthering the study of pathogens and viruses for the betterment of mankind to honor this last request. So they kept working as long as they could before they died from... I guess just old age? I guess they continued to live in here? Maybe they didn't run out of resources? They just expired from age? Not sure. Collins Archive. Boot up. We're hamstrung with only 3 researchers. Decided to make a few modifications to this Mr. Handy robot. Should be really useful for speeding up some of our lab work. I've been pretty anxious since admittance day. As if the world ending wasn't enough. I'm very concerned about all of its motives. Dusting off some of my old robotic chops has been just the distraction I've needed. Oh, so that's how Curie came about. Yeah, just an old Mr. Handy robot, just repurposed to help them with research. Personality profile. I've decided to write a suite of custom personality settings for the robot. She's a little bit of Liza. I really hope she got into her vault down in DC. And a little bit my grad school fling from Versailles back in 46. Or Versailles? Versailles? I think it's Versailles. Something like that. I'm looting her databanks with every great body of work I have access to here. Einstein, Turing, Braun, yep, she'll have so much to learn. It's already made her feel so much more like a peer in the lab, as opposed to an appliance. I'm calling her Curie. I know. I was never a subtle man. Okay, so it was a joke. Therapeutic. Curie's been doing great. Flint's finally stopped treating me like a crazy person for insisting we address her as a human. And I swear Burrow is deferential to her in a way that reminds me of seeing him around Rebecca, back during the drills. It's actually endearing to see. Most importantly, and perhaps more surprisingly, she's bringing a sense of normalcy to the lab, keeping us all a bit more grounded. Anything to keep our minds off the situation we're in is all too welcome. I've tuned her personality matrix a lot, but it's beginning to feel wrong to manipulate her. I'm going to leave her programming alone for now, and just see how she evolves as she keeps learning. Ongoing directive. Haven't touched this terminal in years, not since I gave it to Curie as her own. Seeing her reaction to having something of her own was transformational. It just seemed wrong to violate that, and so it's truly been for her eyes only ever since. This final entry is an exception, and I suppose is being written out of habit, as a man used to a lifetime of recording his experiments. We lost Flint today, and Burrow has to spend more time helping me around the lab than actually performing research these days. So, if only to report my findings, Curie has been a remarkable success. She transcended my expectations of robotic programming. Her... something, and then it cuts off. I wonder if the reason everything keeps getting cut off could be because of the mod that I have, the one that changes the text of talking to NPCs.
Psst.
The one that gives you the full lines of dialogue, there we go, like this. I wonder if the mod that does this could perhaps mess with the entries somehow? I don't think they're supposed to change anything in the entries though, so I don't see how that could be.
I would request we travel extensively and collect data.
So Curie, she's almost a person, it sounds like. At least she was treated like a person. I wonder if she could even be a companion. I wonder if she's enough of a character for that. It wouldn't surprise me. And I'm about to sneeze. Excuse me.
Alright.
Vault 81 Mission Statement. From Vault Tech Board of Directors to Chief Scientist Vault 81 Medical Lab Partition. We are entrusting you with a mission that is critical to all humanity. Vault 81 will be used to wipe out disease as we know it in the human race. Your partition of the vault has been equipped with state-of-the-art medical research equipment, including the new Contagious Vulnerability Robotic Infirmary Engineer, aka Curie. There's a century's worth of biological and chemical supplies. There are the genetically adapted mole rats. And most important, a vault full of test subjects. Cure disease by testing on humans unknowingly. Not too moral. Little bit of a problem with that. Oh, looks like this is a shortcut to go back up. Or down, or wherever we're going. Come on, dog meat. Oh, you're blocking the way, Curie. Nah, they'll find their way. There we go.
It is stimulating traveling with you.
Heads up. Wait there. Moving out.
Where is this going to come out at? Oh, hi! Just comes out right here.
Huh. Looking for a meal? See Maria. She runs the Sunshine Diner in the atrium.
Did nobody find it strange where I just came out of? And also why Kiri is here? No one finds it strange.
The Commonwealth wasn't so dangerous. I'd love to see more of it.
No one cares.
Do you wear your vault suit in the Commonwealth, or just when you visit us?
Remember, no funny business.
Okay, how about dramatic business? Is that acceptable? Let's go give the cure to Forsyth. Oh, we've still got a couple other things to try down here, like giving the Addictol to Tina's brother. Okay, I gotta go to residential first, right? Right?
Your Pip-Boy ever act up on you? Mine's been glitchy lately.
Yeah, residential and then down below.
The cure. You found it.
Here. Take the cure and use it on the boy.
Only one dose?
I hope this works. If it doesn't, there won't be anything to analyze to try again.
Let's hope this works.
I heard you had returned.
It shouldn't be long.
What? Where am I?
You're in the clinic. You were really sick, Austin. Our visitor from the Commonwealth saved your life.
Really? Thanks, ma'am.
I was worried to death about you, Austin.
What got into your fool head? Going into a place like that.
Nothing exciting ever happens here. I just wanted to see what was in there.
Well, if it hadn't been for our friend here, you might have died. Thank you. I know you made sacrifices to help him. I know Dr. Pinsky will be grateful. For my part, I'd like to give you this syringer. I had it for years and never really had a use for it.
She's not the only one. The whole vault is thankful. I'd like to give you a room here in the vault. A place you can call your own. It's in the main hall, on the left as you get off the elevator. Once again, thank you.
I
hope you enjoy your accommodation. I wanted to say thank you again for what you did.
Oh my god, everybody, why is everybody talking?
You opened a lot of eyes around here, including my own. I had no idea of the dangers Vault Tech had hidden away so close to home. I can't believe so many died just behind our walls.
So she actually didn't know, huh? Please, stop pushing me, please. Doctor, thanks.
If Vault Tech had lived to go through with their plan, this place would be wiped out.
I don't doubt that one bit. I hate to think of what they had planned for us. But on the good side, you made a real impression on our anti-Commonwealth people. They're realizing outsiders really can be trusted, and do more good than just providing resources. You'll always be welcome here. And I hope you make a habit of visiting. Having a trusted outsider would help serve as a reminder that the Commonwealth isn't something to fear and avoid.
Glad to hear it. I think I'm gonna dump this syringer, because this made me overweight. Why does the doctor have a syringer rifle? That's kinda weird. Actually, I'm gonna dump the pistol instead, because the syringer rifle's worth more and only weighs very slightly more than the pistol.
Okay. After this, you'd think Bobby DeLuca would have reached out for help by now. That boy is useless.
Hello, Dr. Forsyth.
The dangers of curiosity. Lucky for Austin, he does appear to have 9 lives.
See if there's anything more to do with you.
Without your help, Austin would be dead. Thank you.
Okay, nothing more. Yeah, let's go talk around with people. I still need to give the Addictol to
if you need fixing
Tim's
up,
brother.
Let's get a look at you.
Oh. Nope, nothing there.
A moment, please. I have been trapped so many years. I believe it's customary to thank you for your role in saving me. My entire life has been in this vault. I have analyzed and learned everything there is to know here. So now I must see the rest of the Commonwealth, consult with scientists, unearth more data to challenge my hypothesis.
Oh, that's so cool. So yeah, you can have her as your robo-scientist companion.
What are you looking to learn up there?
Down here is an enclosed system, and without the introduction of new mutagens, viruses, or bacteria, it is quite dull, medically speaking. The world up there is infinitely more complex. Who knows what diseases can be found and studied?
It sounds like the vault could really use you.
Of this, there is no doubt. But I seek to elevate my capabilities, and down here I will stagnate. Please, madame, can you take me with you?
I want her to go back to stay at Sanctuary, but I don't actually want her to replace Dogmeat. Is there an option to do that?
Are you alright?
Yeah, okay, I'm going to say yes, and then I'll just tell Dogmeat. Like, I'll run after Dogmeat like I did before when I accidentally got Preston into my group.
Come along, then.
Excellent. We must embark at once.
Okay, send Dogmeat to Sanctuary. Please don't leave right away, though. Come back, Dogmeat! Hold on! Huh. Oh god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, I'm overweight. Oh no! I'm overweight! I can't sprint after Dogmeat! Because now that I... Oh, that is so bullshit. The Lone Wanderer perk. The Lone Wanderer perk. I said it only applies to humans? That's actually not true. It applies to humans and robots, but not dogs. Dogmeat's the only one it doesn't apply for. Now that I have Carrie in my group, I'm extremely overweight. No! Drop everything. Dogmeat, I'm coming for you!
Dogmeat!
Come on, boy. It's time to go.
Send Kiri to Sanctuary Hills. There we go. Wait, could I not do that? Huh. That's weird. I can't send her there. Okay. In that case... Starlight Driving? Sure. There we go. Dogmeat's back. Yeah,
Kiri's... Never had an incident on my watch. I don't want to start.
This is something before the troubles, yes?
Kiri's a really cool character. But I'm still gonna stick with good old Dogmeat. I'm gonna have Dogmeat for the entire rest of the game. Never gonna change. Okay, what was I doing?
Huh?
Right. Tina's brother, where is that?
You should stop by and see Horatio while you're here. I can't imagine you come across many barbers in the Commonwealth.
Yep, I've already been
to
him, thank you.
Blending in with that vault suit.
Lavatory.
Huh?
I don't remember my way around this place. Reactor. There we go. Bobby DeLuca should be down here.
Hey, I heard what you did for Austin. You saved that kid's life, so I was hoping you could help me out with Bobby.
Yes?
I need someone to get him off the jet. Ever since all that drama, he's gotten worse. Doesn't leave his room, high all the time. Rachel said if he doesn't get help, he could die.
I know exactly what to do. I have the Addictol in my inventory right now, Chloe.
Any idea how I can do that?
You've got to convince him to go see Rachel. She's got some treatment drug that'll help him get clean. It's either get clean or get dead at this point, and that bastard better get his priorities straight.
Oh, maybe I didn't even have to buy the Addictol. Rachel already had it. Get Bobby off chems. Okay, so where actually is Bobby?
Excuse my extremities.
Thought he'd be down there with his sister, but apparently not. Alright, well, he's pretty easy to identify. Kitty cat! Weird
Bet
robot kitty.
I wish he took the tour now.
I wish there were
wish
more children
my mom
to fill
and dad
the classroom.
Wouldn't fight so much.
I can fill your classroom. Actually, apparently not. These seats are apparently too small for me. I can't sit.
Hey, Katie. It'll be a long time before the kids stop talking about you.
Gran says I'm a bottomless pit when it comes to food.
Yes, you've told me that 3 times now, little Jimmy or whatever your name is. Thank you.
Now, where did I put those screws?
Stay safe, ma'am.
Can't believe we had more
seeds,
rats
seeds,
in the
seeds.
Walls.
Okay, seeds.
Seeds. I'll need more seeds.
This right here must be where the observation chamber was looking through, right?
Just the person I wanted to see. I wanted to thank you for what you did for Austin.
How's he doing?
He's recovering well, back to his normal self again. It's as if he doesn't even know what happened. It was a selfless act, something we don't see much of from the Commonwealth. You're a rare breed. The kind we could use more of both inside and out of Vault 81. Anyway, I'm sure you have plenty of things to get back to. I just had to say thank you for saving Austin. I may have my life's work, but that boy is what really keeps me going.
No problem. Okay, so I think we can do something here. She gave me some mute fruit to test out a while ago, and I remember saying that I was going to try to plant it. I thought she wanted me to plant it and see how it would grow, but actually no. She actually just wants me to eat it. So there's a couple kinds of mute fruit. I believe the one she gave me is a different kind from the normal. She gave me fresh mute fruit, I think. Where is it? Yeah, there we go. Fresh mute fruit. So normal mute fruit is wild mute fruit, which gives you a little bit of HP, but also some rads. And what she gave me was fresh mute fruit. So I think she wanted me to eat it and see what it would do, and then go talk to her. Okay. Is that it?
Excuse me, Dr. Penske.
Did you try the fruit? Tell me, how was it?
It was delicious.
It was good. No adverse effects.
I knew it. This is good progress. I'll have to start a new batch right away. Since you've been so helpful, maybe you can help out in another capacity. You see, I need these plants to conduct my studies, and they take some special nourishment, especially the carrots. If you could keep an eye out for fertilizer while you're out in the Commonwealth, I'll be more than happy to compensate you for your efforts.
Oh, so the people of Vault 81, it looks like they can be like a dumping ground for special junk items, fertilizer, and tools. I have seen some fertilizer, but I think I've mostly avoided picking it up because it's heavy and doesn't have that much value.
How much are you paying?
I'll give you 25 caps, non-negotiable. I know how you outsiders enjoy your bartering, but I've never been any good at it.
Fair enough.
Sure, I can do that.
Really? Great. I was dreading having to put in another request to the Overseer. Just bring by whatever you can find whenever you have the time.
Okay, gotta remember to give my tools.
Aaron told me how you saved Austin's life. I guess you're not bad for an outsider.
Great. So do you want to talk down, stop being an asshole to Alexis?
Holt.
If you need something, ask Alexis. I can't make heads or tails of her sort.
I guess that's
nice
a no.
Nice pip boy. If it ever starts acting up on you, see Alexis. She'll fix it right up.
Alright, so I've got a bunch of tools for... Oh no, not for you.
Where... Commonwealth hasn't gotten
you. Where's the guy? Normally he's working on stuff right here.
Excuse me.
Anything I can get you today?
Anything more to say? Nope.
Outsiders.
Outsiders, yeah. The one that just cured the infection in that little boy. Those outsiders? Yeah, we're such assholes.
I hope you don't have anything that needs fixing. I really don't feel like working.
Heard you were down in that secret vault tech area. Can't believe we had a whole colony.
The people here will never forget what you did for Austin.
It's nice to run around and just have everybody praise me.
If you want a good meal, see Maria at the cafeteria.
Okay, I don't know where this tools guy is.
I see that vault suit of yours is still holding up.
I'm gonna go try to find him. Well, I'm not sure where the tools guy is, but there's Bobby, and he's doing Jet right now in front of me. Oh, Bobby.
Hi, Bobby.
Hey, the outsider. I'm just in charge of the generators here, not sure what I can help you with.
I'm here about your habit.
My habit? No habits here, man.
You need to get help, Bobby. Go see Rachel. She has medicine that will help you.
No, wait. It's never that easy.
Oh, I failed.
I ain't going through that withdrawal shit ever again. Besides, I like getting high. It's the only way to pass the time in 81.
Can I just give him my Addictol?
Bobby.
Hey, the outsider. I'm just in charge of the generators here. Not sure what I can help you with.
Tina sent me.
Oh, Jesus. I know what this is about.
Don't you want to quit?
Yeah, well, I do, but I can't. This place, man, and the work, Jet's all that makes it decent.
What do you mean by decent?
Never mind.
I failed again.
You wouldn't understand anyway.
Oh, shit.
You're just a waste of space. I couldn't care less what you do.
Let's try this.
Harsh. Man, really harsh. Even my sister wouldn't say that.
Well, that didn't help.
Hey, Bobby.
Hey, the outsider. I'm just in charge.
I heard you're a junkie, Bobby.
Yeah, well, whatever you heard, it's not true. I ain't no junkie.
We already established you are. What if I try this again? Is it gonna redo the skill check? Probably not.
You need to get help.
No, wait.
Nope.
Besides.
Hi, Bobby.
Hey, the outsider. I'm just in charge.
Sure. You're in charge.
Hey, don't act so surprised. Yeah, I'm in charge. Of the generators, at least. Calvin handles most of the smaller maintenance requests. You got something that needs fixing? You can ask him.
I'm here.
My habit.
You have an addiction, but it's your choice to quit.
Damn straight, it's my choice. I wouldn't even call it an addiction. I mean, I know I could quit if I wanted to, I just don't.
I guess I can't do anything? There's gotta be something I can do. What if I pickpocket him? But instead of stealing from him, what if I give him the Addictol? And then one day, he'll, you know, well, today probably, just some time later in the day, he'll reach into his pockets, pull it out, and he'll go, yeah, yeah. Maybe I should take it. Or, you know, that might happen. Okay, I just loaded my save game. Yeah, let's not piss off every single person in the vault and make them shoot me.
Huh?
So it seems like I've just completely exhausted any possibility of finishing the quests. But perhaps I could talk to Rachel and... or go back to Tina, maybe? Possibly. Let's do it. Let's speak with Rachel.
Yes?
If I could navigate this damn place.
Yes?
Here we go, Clinic. Rachel.
Hello, Rachel.
Feeling all right? I can always take a look.
Nope, can't even mention it. So it's either Tina or nothing. I'm out of options. Alright, let's go back to Tina.
I swear to God, if Bobby ODs, he'll make me wish I killed him myself.
Tina,
all he needs to do is go see Rachel and it's over.
I guess not. Alright, that's it for the quest. Let me just go back to my hunt for the tools guy and then we're done at Vault 81. Well, I tried to look for that tool guy. And I couldn't find him. I even waited around on a bench for, like, 12 hours just to see if he'd come back to that usual spot that I saw him at before, at a different time of day, but he never came back. And of course I searched around for him and also never found him. I'm sure he's there somewhere, I just missed him somehow. So I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. this ends our adventure of Vault 81. At first, it was really cool and promising, and then it seemed like it would maybe be disappointing in that there weren't many quests to do in here. But then, we found Vault 81, the secret Vault 81, and then it got really, really cool again. So this has been a really long kind of quest line and just location to explore. There's so much in here. It took me like 2 hours to fully explore it. It's really cool. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to process all of my junk off screen, and then start doing more quests.